Hello and welcome to Off the Record. My guest today is someone I prefer to call, based on what I've seen in Sivaganga, in Lok Sabha election campaigns over the years, Mr. P. Chidambaram's very own Home Minister. Karthi P. Chidambaram, welcome to the show.
Hello, Karthi. Sanjay. How are you?
Fine, thank you, Karthi. Karthi, you're in the news, on the front page of almost all the newspapers, for the right or the wrong reasons?
I don't know. I must just be thankful for
you made it to the headlines along with your dad as well.
I must just be thankful for somebody to get me to the front pages of three newspapers in one day.
And on channels as well. Karthi, this whole, what did you exactly say about, are you representing the new aggressive face of the Congress in Tamil Nadu?
I don't know whether I'm the aggressive face of the Congress in Tamil Nadu, but I definitely think that I am articulating a point of view.
Which is?
Of the unheard worker.
Which
who's
is?
Sort of been silent and rather been yearning for the 43 years we've been out of government.
Which is?
I think we've reached the point where the average party worker wants a greater role for the Congress in Tamil Nadu.
And what does that mean? Translate into power sharing in 2011?
I think the first step is to become a much more proactive political party. The Congress party is, compared to the true Dravidian parties in Tamil Nadu, which are the dominant political forces, one must agree to that fact. We have been rather passive. We've been passive in terms of propagating our own position, highlighting what.
So, what does this mean? I mean, you're answering in generic terms. What does this exactly mean? Power sharing in 2011?
What it means is that we need to be a lot more proactive and we need to contest in a far more number of seats than we usually contest.
You've come up with some formula, I think, in Tiruvarur. You said, what, 78 seats?
It's not a number. It's not a number which I've pulled out of the hat. I think what would be fair for the Congress is that we are not a party which is confined to a particular region of Tamil Nadu or confined to a particular community of Tamil Nadu. We are a pan-India party and we are present in all districts of Tamil Nadu, right from Kanyakumari up to Hosur.
So, how many seats do you want?
So, there are 39 parliamentary constituencies in Tamil Nadu. Today, with the new delimitation formula, there are 15 parliamentary constituencies in which there is not a single Congress MLA. There are three parliamentary constituencies in the city of Chennai, which is the capital of Tamil Nadu. We don't have a single MLA in the three parliamentary segments. So, what I'm proposing is just a proposal. I mean, obviously, there is support and there is probably a different point of view from others. Is that out of the 39 parliamentary constituencies, we must contest in a minimum of two seats per parliament, two assembly segments per parliament. So, we should contest in about 78 seats. So, we get a pan-Tamil Nadu presence.
You're calling it a proposal. Some of your opponents call it saber-rattling, speaking out of turn, trial balloon.
I think every idea has to be debated and obviously striking a chord. Otherwise, you know, if it's so outlandish, why is people are
reacting? But you were almost sounding for a minute like EVK Selangovan, who's also been making similar demands.
I think he's also articulating a point of view which is quite relevant. He's also striking a chord.
But the Tamil Nadu Congress chief, Mr. Thangabalu, says, don't speak out of turn. He's also issued a gag order.
And I think he said that you should not criticize the alliance as such, but I do not.
Do you believe the alliance is intact? Congress.
I believe the DMK Congress alliance is intact. I think the DMK Congress alliance will only get stronger and more equal in the coming time.
Because there are also overtures from the other side.
That's always happens. The Congress is the most sought after political party in Tamil Nadu. Everybody who understands Tamil Nadu politics, Tamil Nadu electoral politics, clearly knows that whoever the Congress has an alliance with will win. And every time the ADMK has come to government in Tamil Nadu, have only come with the help of the Congress. So it's only natural for large political formations to
seek.
You
don't see that happening though?
No, I think the alliance with the DMK is solid. I think it will continue and I think it will be a winning alliance. Of course, we have certain expectations within the alliance, that's all. But I think the alliance will continue.
When you say most sought after, you must also understand that the Congress is also perhaps the most faction-ridden party. This is especially in Tamil Nadu. You have the Vasan camp and you have the Karthi Chidambaram camp.
No, I think you see sometimes the Congress gets a very wrong rap from the media.
They're denying this. There's no Vasan camp and no Karthi Chidambaram camp.
I mean, there are differences of opinions and different followings within any political party as there would be even within a regional party. It's just that these things don't affect electoral outcomes. There are obviously different styles of functioning. So, because there are different styles of functioning, there will always be slight differences in operating the party. But they don't really affect the party. They don't affect electoral outcome. The Congress vote bank is intact. It's only growing, especially after the Youth Congress membership.
You're sounding like the Tamil Nadu Congress president is something that you aspire to office to.
See, I, I, see, I, my political future is within the Congress party. So whatever opportunities the Congress...
very clear that unlike other, celebrity politicians' sons, children, like Sachin Pilot several others, you don't eye the Lok Sabha. You don't...
No,
I'm
very clear that I would want to be in politics within the party in the state of Tamil Nadu.
You want to be TNCC president soon?
I don't know that I'd want to be TNCC president soon, but if there are opportunities to grow within the organization of the Congress party, of course,
But there are obstacles also, Karthi. Now, Yuvraj, the youth Congress president, has accused you of going uninvited to
Nalapattinam. No, I would not like to take issue with the young man. I attended
he says
five...
says no AICC member no, should no, attend
let, let
youth
me clarify.
Congress.
I attended five meetings on Sunday, on Independence Day. Kumbakonam, Tiruvarur, Tiruthuraipoondi and two in Vedaranyam. I was invited by various Congress functionaries to attend various meetings and various events. And one meeting I was invited, there is even an invitation, along with a former MP, along with the two sitting Congress MLAs, one of whom who is the longest standing Congress MLA, five-term Congress MLA, with a former deputy mayor, current deputy mayor of another city. So I was invited with a host of other Congress functionaries to attend a function of the Youth Congress. It wasn't as if I was gate crashing into a party or something like that. And I was invited.
I think it's not customary for an AICC member to attend. Have you got a show cause notice also from
no,
the Youth Congress?
No, I have not received anything. I have not received anything. Nobody has spoken to me about it. Whatever I see, I'm seeing it from the press.
Okay, and also they also say that he says that you don't have the mandate of Rahul Gandhi to talk about these issues, especially on alliance, on seat sharing and...
I'm expressing the view, as I've said in a meeting in Tirupur, I'm expressing the view of the unheard, unsung worker of the Congress party.
And you stand by it?
I stand by it.
All right.
That is the view I'm expressing. I clearly started my speech in Tirupur where I actually said, came up with the 78 formula, was that I am articulating the view of the unheard, unsung worker of the Congress party. The worker who does not aspire to contest any elections. I, in fact, included myself because I don't seek a seat to contest the next election. I said I am articulating the view of a party worker who is not currently an MLA, who is not currently an MP, who does not propose to contest as an MP or an MLA in the next election.
You don't want to contest even an assembly?
No, no, no. I don't. I'm very clear. I do not want to contest elections now. I would only want to work within the party organization.
All right. Well, Karthi Chidambaram wearing many hats. One of the reasons why we are here at this tennis stadium because he's also somebody who's brought the Davis Cup back to the city of Chennai after 31
years.
But all that and more after a short break.